Hey everyone, and welcome to another quick Lightroom tutorial. Today I'm going to go over enhancing eyes in Lightroom. So first thing I'm going to do is minimize this window so we have a little bit more to work with here. And I'm going to, when I don't have any tools or anything selected, you'll notice that I've got the magnifying glass here by default. So I can just click and zoom in on any area of the image and then click and hold to drag the image around so that I've got the area I'm going to work with nice and zoomed in. Next thing I'm going to do is go over here to the adjustment brush tool on the right hand side of these adjustment tools panels here. And the adjustment brush has a lot of different things that we can adjust that we'll mess with some of these things here in a moment. But for right now, let's focus on the settings for the brush down here. So you'll notice I have auto mask unchecked. If you have auto mask checked, the software will intelligently try to figure out what you're trying to select, and so things can get a little bit hairy if you've got some strange looking pixels to work with that Lightroom can't quite decipher. So I've got that unchecked for now because I don't really need that for this application. My brush size is at about 10. That will vary for you, but you can obviously increase the size of your brush by dragging on this slider. The feather actually adjusts that outer circle that you see on the, let me make the brush larger so you can see what's going on while I adjust the feather. So if I increase the feather, you see that outer circle sort of increases in size. And that outer circle is the area where the effect sort of softens from being in full effect to not being in effect at all. So if you want a softer edge to the effect that you're applying, then that's the way to get it. Flow is going to dictate how fast your paint comes off the brush, I guess, for a lack of a better way of saying that. So I'm going to adjust my brush the way I want it for this particular application, and you can adjust your brush for yourself, or you can make note of my settings here if you'd like that for a starting point. But I'm going to get a brush that's a good size to brush in the eye here, and with just enough of a feather to, you know, soften my hand a little bit. All right, so the next thing I'm going to do is what I like to do when I'm painting an effect in is just to see where I'm painting first before I make any adjustments, is just take the exposure and either crank it way down or crank it way up, whichever you prefer. And then when you're painting in, you can very easily see where that effect is taking place. So we're going to do this here, and yeah, for a second the eyes are going to look terrible, but we'll fix that in just a second. So I've got those eyes painted in, and now I'm gonna take this exposure, and instead of darkening the eyes, I actually wanna brighten them a little bit. So I'm gonna go up past zero a little ways, maybe a half a stop or so, and just brighten the eyes up a little bit in general, the whole eye. Okay, so now that I've got that done, what I can do is experiment with some of these other settings. So if my color temperature in the eye was off, like, if the whites of the eyes were off, I could use the color temperature slider to correct that in this sort of global way for the whole eye. But I'm going to go ahead and zero that out for right now. Contrast might work for you if you want to pump up the kind of punch of the whole eye. You can do that. Again, I don't really need that much contrast added here. I just really wanted to brighten up the whole eye. So you can experiment with all these different settings that are available, but I've done what I wanted to do, so I'm going to move on. I'm actually going to create a new pin. Now, really quickly, a pin is just this little dot here, and that signifies, okay, that's where we started applying that effect. So it left a little pin there. So what we can do is come back later and select that pin. So if I close this adjustment brush tool, you'll notice that pin disappears, but if I come back to the tool, that pin is still there. So I can click on it to select it and then push delete if I want to undo that effect. I'm going to go ahead and hit Control Z to bring that back, and we'll continue working. So I'm going to hit the new button here, which will allow us to create a new pin once we start our next adjustment. So what I'm going to do for the next adjustment is bring my brush size down quite a bit, and I'm just going to paint in on the insides of the eye here, kind of right next to the pupil on the iris there. And we'll do that on both sides. And where you do this may vary depending on, you know, the way the head is turned or the effect that you want or the person's eye shape and things like that. You can add these effects in different areas to your taste. So now that we've got that new adjustment there, you'll see the new pin's been created there. And I'm gonna bring do the same thing. I'm gonna come back up to zero and I'm gonna go a little bit further and you'll see just that little area brightening up, and it really adds a whole new dimension to the eye. So, you know, you can bring the slider over to the right until it's overdone and then bring it back down till it feels just about right. And we'll just go with that. And this is an area where maybe a little contrast might look nice. Again, you may want to mess with the color temperature here. So if I really wanted to bring out the brown kind of towards the middle of the eye there, I can pull my color temperature slider to the right towards yellow, and you see what that's doing there. So, and I could also pull it towards blue if I wanted to, you know, enhance a blue eye, for example. So that's one option there. And in fact, now that we've enhanced the color on that, let's make a new pin and go and paint on the outside there where her eyes are blue, and just try seeing what happens if we'll zero that out. We don't really need to make it brighter. And then we'll bring that towards blue and see what happens. So we've really, really gone crazy with the effect here. I'm gonna back that off. And then I'm gonna actually go back and select the last pin we were on. I'm gonna back that off a little bit too, because that was a little too much. One thing that really happens when people first get started, and even after a lot of experience, is you'll overdo an effect a lot of the time and notice it later, well, that's a little much, and you'll need to go back in and fix that and just reduce the overall effect a little bit. So I'm gonna deselect the adjustment brush, now that goes away, and then I'm gonna hit my before and after view down here, and you can see kind of the before and after effect there, what we've done to the eye, which looks pretty cool. So we can go ahead and go back to our normal view, zoom out, and just make sure that in the overall scheme of things, we haven't gone too far, made the eyes look a little fake, and that sort of thing. So now that we've brightened up these eyes, her teeth, you know, we might want to brighten up the teeth a little bit in order to match that, so it doesn't look like her teeth are dull now compared to the nice bright eyes we have in the shot. So again, this is a little bit overdone for demonstration purposes. I'd probably go back if I had actually done this and back everything off a little bit and maybe brighten the teeth. So check out my other tutorial on whitening teeth in case that's your next step. All right, thanks a lot, and I'll see you guys next time.